I'm Ashley Cataldo, Curator of Manuscripts at the American Antiquarian Society. Curators at AAS connect audiences with objects such as the manuscript poems of Phyllis Wheatley.
The manuscript collections at AAS focus on four areas of collecting: papers of prominent early New England families, New England business, association, and family papers, New England diaries, and United States book trades history. The Wheatley poems don't fit easily into any of these categories. So how did they end up at AAS? Wheatley was a young girl when she was taken from her home in West Africa, brought to Massachusetts, and enslaved by a family in Boston. She received an education from the family who claimed to own her and started writing poetry as a young girl. She wrote what we think is her first poem to the University of Cambridge in 1767 when she was about 15 years old. Wheatley would go on to become the first African American to have a book published. When AAS's librarian in the 1830s, Christopher Columbus Baldwin, acquired collector Thomas Walcott's personal library in 1834, he likely came across these poems in Walcott's attic. Walcott was a personal friend of Wheatley's, and she sent her poems to him when he was a student at Dartmouth in the 1770s. His handwriting is on the back of the poem to the University of Cambridge. When Baldwin was in Walcott's attic, he described the manuscripts, books, and newspapers that were, as he said, in ancient trunks, bureaus and chests, baskets, tea chests, and old drawers. Everything was covered with venerable dust, and as I was under a slated roof and the thermometer at 93, I had a pretty hot time of it. Nothing but a love of such work could inspire any man to labor in such a place. We might imagine these poems to the University of Cambridge and on the death of the Reverend Dr. Sewell, covered with dust in Walcott's attic on that hot day, making their way to AAS's first hall with Baldwin and sitting safely on our shelves for years, even as we moved twice. Scholars have used these poems to create scholarly editions of Wheatley's works, write articles about the poet, and even inspire new poetry, as in the case of past fellow Honoré Jeffers' book, Age of Phyllis.
If you have questions about this object or any other manuscript material at AAS, please email me at the address below. Thank you for your interest in the American Antiquarian Society.